When you launch a new Smaart Data Modeler project, you will be prompted to choose a filter reference mode, confirm your filter width selection, and add DSP channels to the project. Select the mode which matches your DSP device or amplifier. If you do not see the manufacturer that you are using on this list, select Generic. If you would prefer to use Q instead of Bandwidth, use the dropdown to the right of mode to change your preference. You can also do this from DSP settings. The filter reference mode, however, cannot be changed once you start adding EQ filters. Below the filter reference mode selections, you can enter the number of DSP channels you wish to work with, as well as name them. Of course, you can also add DSP channels directly from the main interface. Data Modeler is built from the familiar Smaart version 9 interface, where measurement data is on the left portion of the GUI, graphs are plotted in the center section of the interface, and control is on the right. In the DSP channels bar, each DSP channel represents a potential system output, where Smaart measurement data are contained within. DSP channels support linking, which allows you to create a hierarchy of DSP settings that affect all DSP channels contained within the link on top of their individual channel settings. In the DSP settings bar, you will find common controls like polarity, level, and delay. Below the delay control, you may add EQ filter blocks, where the type of filter available is determined by the filter reference mode that you have selected. In the plot area, you will notice a new icon, not available in the mainline Smaart measurement applications, which toggles between the DSP trace or the measurement trace as the top of the Z order of the magnitude plot. Finally, in the upper right corner of the control bar area, you will see three modal buttons which change the DM interface from the general default DSP modeler mode, system EQ response mode, and summation mode. There are multiple ways to import measurement data into Data Modeler. From a DSP channel, select Import Trace. DM will automatically open the root data folder of Smaart Suite. If you do not have Smaart Suite installed, DM will open your computer's Documents folder. If you already have your file management system open, Data Modeler supports drag and drop directly into the DSP channels bar. If you have Smaart open on the same machine and enough screen real estate available, you can drag and drop directly from any version of Smaart 8 or newer, including all editions of version 9. And for an even more streamlined experience, you can create a new DSP channel or even an entire Data Modeler project directly from any edition of Smaart version 9.4 or newer. In system EQ response mode, the raw measurement data of a system, as well as its DSP channel settings, are graphed in the upper system EQ magnitude plot. Any effects of equalization are graphed in the lower result magnitude plot, as well as transfer function target curves, if you are using them. In SCR mode, when you select Invert in the lower right of the control bar, any cuts in EQ are graphed as boosts, allowing you to create complementary EQ curves and see the result of those in the bottom magnitude plot. When you switch back to modeler mode, those settings are kept, and the EQ curve is reverted back to its normal, non-inverted state. Summation mode is designed to model the interaction between two or more measurements taken from the same location, but with different measurement time reference values. Let's take a look at an example using electronic data, where one trace has a measurement time reference of 0 milliseconds, and the other has an MTR of 2 milliseconds. When we select these measurements for summation, Data Modeler calculates this 2 millisecond difference and applies that as positive time offset in the upper relative phase plot. As we apply DSP delay to counter that time offset, we can watch as the summation trace reaches ideal summation when the DSP delay value gets closer to 2 milliseconds. Now, let's take a look at sum mode with real-world data. Both of these measurements were taken at the same location, one of a main speaker and the other as a delay speaker. The measurement microphone was placed in front of the delay speaker. When we select these measurements for summation, the time offset value is calculated and applied to the earlier arriving system, in this case, the delay system. As we add DSP delay to that output, you can watch as their phase traces begin to align. When you leave sum mode and return to modeler mode, the time offset calculated will remain applied to the measurement data, So what you will be looking at is the result of the DSP delay alignment for that system. When aligning mains to subwoofers, the measurement time reference is the same for both the main and sub data, as what we are looking for is the difference in their phase responses at the timing location. We can do this in sum or modeler mode, as there is no time offset to account for in their measurement time reference. In this example, we can see that the acoustic crossover of this system is about 100 Hz, and in the phase response, the subwoofer has a steeper slope at that frequency than the main. Steeper phase slope indicates more time offset, and that we need to delay the main system in order for it to match the phase response of the subwoofer system. I'll select these two measurements for summation, and then add delay to the main system until we reach our ideal phase alignment in summation, in this case, about 12 milliseconds. Once you have completed modeling the optimization and alignment of a system, you can export those settings to a PDF for manual entry into your system processing. As the data modeler platform matures, we hope to add the ability to export directly to specific DSP devices. For now, we can export to a platform-agnostic universal JSON format created specifically for manufacturers to adopt if they choose. We call this the LPIF, or Loudspeaker Processor Interchange Format. In partnership with Eclipse Audio, more information on LPIF can be found on their website.